fourth phase, and one that is the long-term future requirements would be to develop the area behind the park maintenance building at Fort Williams Park. This area does, however, have significant limitations, and this phase would be implemented only if it is found in the future to be truly necessary. This is from a report in November of '85.
Of '85?
'85.
In your definition of industrial league, do you consider that to be adult, any adult kind of group, not just industrial league?
I think that's what they're generally called.
Under the site plan review, this would include a stormwater control provision analysis?
It would include the full requirements of site plan review as contained in the zoning ordinance of the town of Cape Elizabeth, which includes everything from seeing if there's adequate water to toilet facilities to stormwater to vegetation, you name it.
Okay. Any comments from other councilors? Because I was going to make a comment. Go ahead.
Yes, so where are we at with the Sunday deal?
It's still no games at the moment.
At the moment.
That's the way the motion reads.
There's one thing I didn't mention before. That there's one lady in the house that remembers a game the same as I do, kick the can.
Okay, I have thought very long and hard about this. I really hadn't made a decision before I came tonight, and I still have mixed feelings. I think I am very concerned about the number of people who are opposed to this particular location. And I'm not talking about abutters, and I'm not talking about joggers or just walkers, but the whole ambiance of the fort and the fact that this is one of the few areas that is quiet. I have been over there at least six times in the past few weeks, walking around and looking at different angles and staring at the Guthrie's porch and looking out towards the lighthouse. There is no doubt that there is a very strong need for new fields in this town. I mean, there was when my children were playing youth sports, and I won't tell you how many years ago that was. Perhaps one of the suggestions tonight that would be best for us to reevaluate is a better management of our fields. I realize some of the high school fields need to rest during the summer, but if we could computerize the fields, their use, their whole scheduling, perhaps we could come up with more available space than we currently have. I think that in talking with the manager, he and I have been out separately on different weekends looking at the intensive use of the current areas of the fort that are already developed, and that I really feel that as a town council, we need to think twice before we approve a use like this, and perhaps even should do a reevaluation of the master plan. It is a plan that is a proposal. It's nothing that is written in stone, and it can be amended and reevaluated from time to time. It is a first pass, although very thorough, examination of use of the area, but times have changed greatly since even in the past 5 years with the demands we have. So I feel that we should fully concentrate on developing land that's currently available, that the Lions Field should be a priority in your development. And I want to ask, is there room out there also for the same soccer field in that particular area, or is it just a little league field? It is. That should be the primary focus, and perhaps even though it is more expensive, you still would be able to find the funds privately raised to support that particular development. Those are my particular feelings on this issue. So if they're, Ms. Reed.
Madam Chairman, I just have a couple of observations regarding yours. Computer use and scheduling is not, I've just spent 3 years on the school board, so I can take myself out of the Little League youth soccer role and into the school board member role that's only a year ago. How about the extensive use of the school's fields and computer inputting of the fact that there are 150 more kids in the high school than there were 5 years ago, and the fact that there is 140 or 150 students in kindergarten replacing the 99 graduating on a regular basis. The fact that Little League season is a stated Little League season, the fact that the sun goes down, and that the fort closes at 8 o'clock. I just really want to give some credit to the scheduling that has already been done on the fields, and you heard tonight that there has been a commitment to establish a girls lacrosse team, which is going to require the schools to find another layer of hours in which the student athletes can play. And since 10 years ago this was an identified site, I think we really ought to consider it where it is publicly owned and controlled. Thank you.
Other comments? If not, I'll move the question. All those in favor of passing this on to the planning board with the stated conditions, take a roll call vote.
I believe we have an amendment.
You want to take care of the amendment first?
The amendment was approved by the person who made the motion, and the seconder approved it. So that's so that's already been done. I'm doing a roll call vote.
Councilor Chappell?
Against.
Councilor Jordan?
No.
Councilor McGinty?
Yes.
Councilor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Councilor Reed?
Yes.
Chairman Cogsall?
No. It's a tie.
Three nays.
Madam Chairman, I believe
yes,
the people in the room would like to know what the outcome was.
The
they
outcome
don't understand.
The outcome was a tie of three yays, three noes. The motion fails. We still have some items on the agenda that we need to address tonight. I'd like a motion to suspend the town council rules to take up some of the following items.
Madam Chairman, due to the hour and the number of items that we have on the agenda, and I'm going to try to finish this agenda or move on to tomorrow evening. It's just a question.
Let's see. There are. There are several items that we probably could address that are going to be set for public hearing or just a simple approval of something from the planning board recommendations. We could consider.
It's just a question. I mean,
right.
I don't know
it's
the feeling. When I was younger, we could go into one. But
it's recommended that we continue until item 18.
Item 18?
The end of the year transfers. By charter, we have to also do the end of the year transfers.
I don't know.
Okay.
What do you want, though?
And we also have police contract, or they won't get paid.
I think we should go home until tomorrow.
We could table various items if you want until next month. There are certain items that we do need to address right now.
Well, as we go down through them, if I may, Madam Chairman, as we go down through them, you're going to make the comment of possibly of tabling. Is that correct?
We're up on
okay.
Consent of the recommendation of the manager. Item number 12, to consider setting a public hearing on a report from the planning board regarding the possibility of permanent restroom facilities at Fort Williams Park and take any necessary action.
The staff is recommending that this be referred to a council workshop for further review.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? Okay, we'll set this to a workshop.
Need a vote?
A vote on that?
A vote in favor? 5-0. Item number 13, to consider proposed amendments to the Planning Board rules and regulations and take any necessary action. Mr. McGovern?
Yes, this is a rather routine updating of the Planning Board rules and regulations or bylaws simply to reflect current practices. Some of the changes as a result of other things that the council has moved in the ordinances, change in the numbers of members. There are a few other things that typically the Planning Board does in a certain way, electing their chairman at a certain time, and they have forwarded these to you with a recommendation for approval.
I understand that, but I don't agree with some of it. And I know I got to modernize, but I see chairperson should still be there.
Chairman, yes.
Chairman and what have you, anything like that. I'd like to argue that out sometime, but.
If I could just go back, we did have a motion and a second for suspending the rules. I don't believe we voted to do that. Just to be on the safe side. All in favor? 5-0.
Yes, I guess so.
So is there a motion on item number 13?
Which item?
This item number 13, which is the Planning Board rules as recommended. This was a recommendation from the Appointments Committee as well as forwarded by us to the Planning Board, and they're coming back with their approval.
Well, I think we should look at it before we flatly. Maybe other ones have different ideas, that's all. That's my point.
This was part of the changing of the number. I guess Janet's not here. When she was chairman of the committee, we changed the membership of the Planning Board from 5 members to 7 members, and it's changing that as well as the actual appointment date and the time of the month when they actually meet has been reorganized. They did eliminate the term chairman and vice chairman and made it non-gender. I don't have a problem with that. This is something that's been through 2 or 3 committee processes already. Mr. Linnell, were you on that committee at the time?
No.
The Appointments Committee?
Oh, I'm sorry.
When this change from 5 to 7 members
was
made?
Yes, yes.
So this was just changing the ordinance to update it to reflect what the decision
right,
has
been. Right, and to make it gender neutral, essentially. Right. That's right.
Do you move?
Sure, I'll move it.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor? Item number 14, to consider report from the Planning Board on a proposed amendment to the zoning ordinance regarding the jurisdiction of the Zoning Board of Appeals upon appeals of sewer issues and take any necessary action. This item two is also a reflection of the change in the jurisdiction and in the zoning ordinance. To make a change, we have to forward it to the Planning Board for their approval and then back to us. Mr. McGovern, do we have standards under 15.18C for them to make these decisions?
Yes, we do.
There are specific standards for them to use? Okay.
So it's all set to move forward then?
It's all set to move forward, right.
So move.
Is there a second? Discussion? All those in favor?
Did I vote?
That was a 5. Did you vote this time for us?
Yes, I
thank you
very
much.
I was voting on. She
that's
told
a 5-0. It was a 4-0 on the previous. Janet's not here. Item number 15.
15.
To consider a request from the residents of Sherwood Forest area to amend the traffic schedule to permit year-round parking on Little Joan Road near Plaisted Field and take any necessary action. Mr. McGovern?
I'd recommend it be tabled the next meeting.
So moved.
Second.
In favor?
Discussion?
Oh, sorry.
Okay, it's a tabling motion. It's a tabling motion, there's no discussion unless we want to...
Let's give them a chance to speak, they waited all night.
Unless you want to withdraw your tabling motion in second, it's the only way we can...
I didn't realize you wanted to speak. If he's here, I'm always game for people that's here to speak. I'll withdraw my motion. If I can get the second, I'll withdraw.
Yeah, I'll withdraw mine also. Wait, sure.
My name is Bill Doolin, I live at 989 Shore Road on the corner of Little John. Approximately about 2 months ago, the electric board passed the law that we'd have no parking on the right-hand side or the left-hand side, depending on which side of Little John you go down. To eliminate parking on both sides of the road where in case of emergency, a vehicle, as a fire truck, ambulance could get through that way. If we take that parking line, no parking down on that long side, from the ball games, that I do not have any thing against parents going to see the ball game, because I raised 5 boys and I went to many a ball game. But I do believe we should have an area for emergency vehicle to get down through, and if 2 cars cannot come through that area with cars parked on both sides of the street, and it's very difficult even with cars parked on one side of the street. So I think we should continue to have this no parking, because it's only for 3 months anyway, from April to during
May to October.
Yes, May to October. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'd like to add just one thing to what I just said.
All right, if you come to the microphone, please. Would you spell your last name for us? It's getting late.
D. David, U. B. L. E. R.
L. E. R., okay.
Now I forgot what I wanted to add. and basically it's the same thing with the emergency vehicles going down the road. At the previous meeting, the people down the street further down Little John made the comment that it only happens once, maybe the maximum twice. I think they just said once occasion when this happens. It happens regularly. If we have no parking signs on our side of the road, people automatically park on both sides. In fact, we've had them park halfway into our driveway and say, oh, but we're only going to be here for a little while. So, I mean, there's no consideration taken into the people that live on that side of the road. If Sherwood Forest feels, which we are a part of, that, and I couldn't quite understand how he related it to New York City, but he did relate it in some respect last time to that, degrading his neighborhood or something, that's fine if you want to take it out from that point. But we have 2 of those no parking signs on our properties, on the length of our property, and it really has helped us tremendously. And we would like to see it continue at least half of that street, if nothing else.
Thank you.
Madam Chairman, I had a call today about, I had quite a few calls, in fact, but one caller, and I can't remember his name, and I left it home, that is calling about the ball field, and also, I want these people to hear this, that he would like to have the signs taken down, and I can't remember his name, because they're right in front of it, his house and what have you, and the sign says May to October, and the games really start in April, and what have you, so... I think we need some discussion here, and I hope these people will contact
the... Well, the board passed that, sir. They passed the sign to say no parking, period. And when they got put up, that's what Public Works put up. So they changed it to Public Works from what the board passed. But you passed, the board passed the...
If you're going to continue, come down the mic, please.
Yeah.
From April to October, from October to April, the snowplows have complete jurisdiction of the road. so there's no parking on the road at that time. And when the Little League starts up in April, it's the way it happened is they did not continue it from April 15th. They skipped the two-week period. I don't know why. But there's 2 weeks in there that you could park on both sides of the road, but there's nobody there to park anyways. And they just made it from May to October.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, so the actual motion is May 1st through October.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. So that's it. Yes, May 1st to October 1st is the actual wording.
Okay, you'll be hearing from him.
Do you want a table now?
I move for a table.
Second?
I'll second that, no.
In favor?
Table indefinitely.
Not just table, generally. Table, area.
Okay.
Not indefinitely. Item number 16, to consider a citizen request to amend the zoning ordinance to permit the construction of an addition to a dwelling unit in a critical wetland buffer when the area of construction slopes away from the wetland and take any necessary action.
Yes,
Mr. McGovern?
Yes, Mr. Coles, who is the letter writer along with Mrs. Coles, is here to answer questions and perhaps to briefly identify the issue if the council desires, or if he desires.
It's kind of late for us to be getting into something quite this heady.
Well, I think it's
if you
heavy.
If you want to say...
I would recommend just that the council pass it on for review by let the appropriate planning department take a look at it. Just with houses in a wetland buffer already, we want to put a 6-foot addition, a 6-by-8-foot addition to our front entryway, which is rotted out, and everything slopes away from the wetland, which I'm very sensitive to. And it just seems to me that when you create the basic ordinance, which was created, by the way, without our knowledge, we were never notified that we were being put into this buffer zone. That's fine, but I think it's just a question of why do you set up a buffer to a wetland, and I think the planning board can address that issue and let it move forward to at least that level. I don't think it needs to be debated at great detail here. I don't think you're giving up a lot of rights here, but I think that clearly a wetland buffer is to protect the wetland. If it's flowing away from the wetland, I think it might be an amendment to an ordinance that makes sense.
You were denied a building permit by the code enforcement officer.
That's correct, yes.
Have you gone through the appealing to the Board of Zoning Appeals?
We did not appeal because it would have to be that we thought that the officer had made an incorrect interpretation of the ordinance, and we did not feel he had done that. We just felt that the ordinance needed to be relooked at for its intent and purpose, and this was probably just never considered, that the slope of the buffer, if the wetland's here and the addition is here and everything is flowing away from the wetland, it seems to me that that common sense would probably have somebody say, we never thought of that. Why don't we just allow where it's not affecting the wetland, why don't we make a change to the ordinance? And he did not make a mistake in his interpretation of the ordinance.
Okay, this would be, we could pass it on to the planning board and have them discuss the issue, but usually amending an ordinance, we'd have to see if there was a greater problem in the town to really deal with a change in the ordinance.
I know there's more than one house involved. I don't know what greater means, but I know that there's actually a house to the right of me that wants to do exactly the same thing that's even further away from the wetlands. And it would appear to me that there are probably other situations out there where the buffer, it would appear to me that the ordinance will probably go through a life of change as the intent is to protect the wetland. And if it looks like there is absolutely no protection to a wetland being given by a citizen's request, that appropriate changes to the ordinance, which are made by human beings to protect the environment, if they in fact don't help protect the environment and they hurt human beings that live in the town, it seems to me it makes sense to look at those things. I don't think this is the last possible little thing, but I think there are people out there, we certainly know of one other besides ourselves, so.
I know they did do some considerable amending and allowing even any expansion at all in the buffer. I don't know if the, how the council feels, if you want to pass this on to the planning board to have them study it?
Is that the proper procedure? You figure the planning board? That's what I think, and I, because I feel it should be granted.
I don't think it should be going to the ordinance committee because it would just be forwarded on to the planning board anyway.
So it would have to, it's got to go to the planning board sometime.
Exactly.
So moved.
Any further discussion?
To the planning board. Everybody understand my quick motion?
Are you voting? You were, okay. All those in favor? 6-0 to the planning board.
Thank you.
Item number 17, to consider a request from Juan Perez to extend a sewer to Wells Road and onto his property adjacent to Wells Road and take any necessary action. Mr. McGovern?
Yeah, it's proposed that you set a public hearing on this proposal for your July 10th meeting. The public hearing would have, in essence, three facets to it. One would be an amendment to the 1984 Supplemental Wastewater Facility Plan, the draft of which you have in your packet. The second of which would be looking at this in the context of growth areas as contained in the comprehensive plan. And three would be the approval of the actual sewer extension.
So moved.
Madam Chairman, where this
Mr. Jordan.
Project might, if goes, will go by my property, I think I should abstain from voting on this issue, and I'll step down if you feel it's necessary. Otherwise, I'll sit here and relax.
You may relax, but don't perhaps not participate. Since we're setting it for public hearing, we need specific times and dates. We have
a meeting.
In the town hall, okay. Is there a second to that?
Second.
Discussion? No discussion? All in favor? Item number 18, to consider a proposed change in employee holidays for fiscal 1996 only, whereby July 3rd, 1995, would be a paid holiday, and Patriots Day 1996 would be an in-service day for non-union employees, and take any necessary action. Mr. McGovern?
I think the agenda item, as you've just read it, Madam Chairman, is self-explanatory. It has been reviewed with the department heads as well as with our personal advisory committee, and while there was some opposition to it, it tended to be people who could easily get July 3rd off anyway. It was those that wouldn't be the ones stuck working. But other than that, I think there was one against it in public works. But people were generally in favor of it.
Madam Chairman.
Mr. Jordan.
I don't know. Maybe I don't understand it. Is that Monday, July 3rd of 1995 or 1994?
It's a typo.
Four on the paper.
It's 1995.
95.
Should be five, right?
Oh, that's in my memo. The years are wrong in the council item. It's
oh, wrong. Sorry.
I was a little behind the times. I'm sorry.
Is there a motion?
I move it be granted.
Second. Discussion. In favor?
This will not cost the town any money. Is that correct?
Oh.
It's late at night, and it's tough to think. The only place I'm hesitating is the refuse disposal area, because it's going to be open both Mondays. It would have been anyway, so it might cost us a few bucks.
But they would have been open.
It would have been open anyway.
As far as giving the other employees the day off, that
one doesn't. No, but there may be a little bit of cost there at the refuse disposal area. Because the plan is that would not close, because we would not want the refuse disposal area closed Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. It would be open on Monday.
In favor?
Everybody happy? Yeah.
No. Oh, I think it's wonderful.
Okay, the 6-0. Item number 19, to consider authorizing certain balances to be carried forward into fiscal year 1996 and take any necessary action. Mr. McGovern.
Yes, I provided you a fairly lengthy list with very short explanations. If anyone would like any amplification, I'd be happy to provide the same.
Comments?
The only comment I have is the dollars from the recycling account. Is that something that you've taken in as the people come to the dump, or is that other funds that's left over in the account?
Yeah. That was money that was appropriated by the town council originally about 5 years ago for recycling purposes. And what it's done is whenever the recycling committee proposes new signage or minor repairs or a mailing sent out to everyone in town about recycling, we pay for it out of this account.
Okay.
Other questions? If not, a motion?
I'll move. So move that they be granted.
Second.
As presented, any other questions? Discussion? Mr. McGinty, you're voting?
Voting.
You're crushing me. All those in favor? It's a 5-0.
You need another copy, I get two.
Okay. Item number 20, to consider authorizing certain year-end transfers and take any necessary action. Mr. McGovern.
Yes, proposing five. One is the police department. Overtime was more than anticipated for the reasons stated. Dispatching overtime was slightly over for the reasons stated. The wet team van ended up was all corroded underneath. It would not get an inspection sticker. We wanted it to be safe. We invested in it rather than buying a new vehicle, so that was over budget. Refuse disposal, when Bob Malley put together the budget for brush and demolition a little over a year ago, he defined the estimate as a crapshoot, quote, in the budget. And it proved to be that, and it proved to be a little bit more expensive than he anticipated. We also had a very expensive year in legal and audit and professional services. You have a list of every last nickel we have spent in those different accounts, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you have, not only on the transfer, but any single listed expense.
Any comments? Have a motion first, and then we can discuss it.
I'll move that the transfers be granted.
Is there a second?
As stated.
Is there a... Rosemary?
Madam
Discussion?
Chairman.
Yes, Mr. McGinty.
A question, maybe it's a procedural one. Have all the funds from all the various accounts in these departments been expended? I think the wet team certainly has been, but for instance, the police department?
Not yet. This is the projection to June 30th.
So are there funds within the, for instance, the police department budget that could be transferred into, you've mentioned the overtime account,
yeah,
that would offset?
This already takes account of those accounts within the department where there are surpluses. This is the...
That's all fact.
This is the net need at the end after you look at all the net pluses and minuses within the individual line items.
Okay, thank you.
The chief gave me an outline of all those, and actually his number was about 2,000 less than the one amount I'm requesting here, but I didn't fully trust his numbers.
In your report that there are some unencumbered balances that...
Right. Okay. This accounts for both positive and negative balances in a number of accounts.
Other comments? Those in favor? 6-0. Item number 21, to consider approving the annual liquor license for the Good Table Restaurant and take any necessary action. Thank you for staying with us for so long tonight. Debbie?
Yes, before you have the annual liquor license for the Good Table. They're requesting a malt, spirituous, and vinous full-time liquor license. The application is before you. It is complete. Mr. Christopoulos is here. We recommend that you approve the reapplication.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor? It's a 6-0.
According to this, it says that the comment period shall be provided prior.
There is only Mr. Van Fleet wishes to comment. He's the only other person.
Mr. Dodd, Mr. Christopoulos.
And Mr. Dodd, right. Mr. Christopoulos is here.
Well, I just thought the opportunity, if that is the process, that the opportunity should be.
Do they?
All in favor? Do we vote?
They don't care to comment?
6-0, okay.
Three.
Item number 22, to consider the status of negotiations with the Cape Elizabeth Police Benevolent Association.
Madam Chair.
And take any necessary action. Councilor McGinty.
Although I don't believe a conflict of interest exists, I would abstain from any discussion regarding this item, considering my prior employment with the police department.
I'm inclined to agree with what you're saying, but as of 7:30, I think you went beyond that point.
Well, I just don't want to have a perceived conflict one way or the other. So
the consensus of the council, we agree with Councilor McGinty.
Yes.
All right, you may abstain from this. Mr. McGovern?
I have a question on that. I think the presumption is this time only, since when these negotiations started, Councilor McGinty was Officer McGinty and was involved on the peripheral of the negotiations.
Right, that's one.
I left open the possibility you could discuss this in executive session by putting it at the end of the agenda. Do you feel that's necessary?
No.
Fine. The contract is a two-year contract, 3% each year. It changes the vacation policy, so it's consistent with the vacation policy of all other town employees. It provides for premium pay during a number of shifts on Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's, so that employee who works Christmas Day, New Year's Day, Thanksgiving Day, and the eves of Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve would be paid time and a half when they actually work during those times, as recognition of the time away from their family. It also includes family medical leave language, similar to what's in the personnel code. Other than that, it's a little bit of housekeeping here and there. I'm very pleased to say that for the first time, the contract is with the Cape Elizabeth Police Benevolent Association and not with the Cape Elizabeth Police Patrol Men's Association.
Yes, we now have a female officer.
You don't need any vote on that anyway.
Well, what I'm asking is I'm recommending you approve the contract.
So moved.
Sign it.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Anything.
6-0.
You want money?
5-0. Oh, 5-0. You're right, Mr. Mayor.
Oh, we're going right through the agenda here.
Item number 23.
I
think we should have it another time.
We can't do that tonight.
No.
Not in good conscience.
So we'll postpone that to our next meeting, Mr. McGovern. Is that right?
Yeah.
Pick it up.
What is the urgency as well?
That's what I'm asking.
The law reads that they must be done within 30 days of the application.
And the application date is?
The council's going to be having a workshop, I think. When is it?
We're having a workshop July 13th.
It's 31 days.
Is there a date on here? Did you find a date, Bill?
Well, it can't be.
Oh, 4,
it's at least the 12th. I mean,
there's a date on the application. On
they both came in approximately 2 weeks ago. I don't know the exact dates, but they were both about 2 weeks ago. One is 4/3/95. That was the original, but it was supplemental data.
Okay.
And she filled. No, it didn't come in that late. The other is May 25th, but it's unsigned application.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
I believe it's also an incomplete application.
One of the difficulties with these applications is...
No, the requirements are not with it, or at least in my packet.
One of the difficulties with these applications is the fact that you have to take them at their face. We try to help people with them, but you take them at their face value for what they are. So
if you feel that it's incomplete, then perhaps we should go back to this individual and ask for the balance, and that would be the extension we need.
you know, I think what you would need to do is to guarantee that if this delay costs them more money, you would make them whole, you know, in terms of interest expense that as a result of, you know, the delay. It's, you know, it's they aren't simple issues, either one. And you know, I do, obviously, publicly, we can't talk about them, but, you know, you could be a good 45 minutes, and I question voting at 1:15.
That would make it about 2.
I would say that, that the applicants would not be penalized because of our need to have a later meeting. Is that consensus of everyone
Very good.
Here? Yeah. Councilor Reed.
How do we go about getting the additional information?
I will work with each individual, but I publicly, it's not a whole lot I want to say to answer that.
Okay.
I just want to remind us that we have our workshop on 7:13, and I guess we probably will have go into executive session that night to deal with this issue.
There'll be a special meeting set up.
Special meeting, okay, to deal with this.
To do that.
That David Jolicoeur has arranged for the town picnic to be Tuesday, June 27th from 2 to 4 at the community center. And I hope Councilor Chappell will man the grill.
June 27th?
June 27th, yes. That you'll man the grill again this year.
I'll be there painting in the morning, and I'll be glad to help at noontime.
You cooking?
It's great.
2 p.m.
What time?
2 to 4.
Two? Wonderful. Can I have
But if you're
hat?
Cooking, you got to be there a little earlier.
Yes, I'll bring your hat.
I don't know.
2 p.m.
2 p.m.
Bill, you'll have to make that because I need an assistant chef.
Thank you.
Citizens discussion, a period of items not on the agenda. There being none, then I'll take a motion for adjournment.
You've got it.
Second.
All in favor? Would you like to go home? Yes, 6-0. I want to welcome both counselors. I'm sure you realize this is not the usual.
If two residents stay here until this time, I don't have a word to say.
We have a good time.
Thank you.